My name is Shaun Overton, and I'm turning this into a desert forest. This is by far one of my favorite trips because this was the first volunteer event. The main thing we've accomplished this trip is building check dams. The first one of these I built is just right here. And you can see like what is effective about it because it's already backfilled with sediment in the cracks.
Yeah, you can see that.
So the idea of situating it here is I only did this in February. So there's like this natural collection of vegetation. There's this narrow choke point, and I had easily accessible rocks and some time to kill. We had lost a track, and I was bored, so I made a check dam.
And then did you dig that hole up there?
No, that was with a mini excavator.
Oh, okay.
What I'm hoping you guys can help me with is in this main water channel, pretty much any time you find a choke point and a big collection of rocks.
Rocks there.
Put rocks there.
Okay.
Yeah, rehome the rocks. What'll happen over time is that these plants are here because there's already more water than usual, and we're adding even more water by helping them grab it from the soil. I worked with NRCS, which is a government agency, to estimate how much soil I'm losing every year due to rain. In an average year, I should lose about 3.5 yards of silt and sand.
Per acre?
Per acre. So, like, that's still a lot, but for this area, it's not too bad.
Mm-hmm. Because there's nothing left.
Yeah, there's nothing left. Like, it's pretty bare. Like, we got little patches of grass.
And how far up does your property end?
30 or 40 feet that way. The reason we're working here is you see how that ridge line goes in a bowl?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So this is the start of the watershed.
Yeah.
And I almost own the exact top of the watershed. And the idea is that if we keep collecting water in here, we're going to build up the water pressure in the soil. And hopefully the water pops out one day, but
we'll see.
This is probably the best place because these are a little close together. But maybe every like 50 feet.
Okay. So right there.
Yeah. And they're literally a pile of rocks. The cornerstone is laid.
Yeah.
I know, man. They're hauling.
Remember what I said about 20-year-olds?
Yeah, I know. If you're under 25, you better get out here.
Yes, definitely.
You guys are flying.
This would be the worst time to hit each other with rocks.
Yeah. This is well on camera.
Or the best time.
Yeah. Yeah, what is it? Ready, fire, aim. I definitely approve of the technique. No, it's great. Like, that's what's nice about the elevation of this valley is you just pick up these giant boulders and chuck them.
Yeah.
And honestly, like, the way you're throwing them is probably gonna lock the rocks just as well as if you were carefully stacking them.
Yeah. Like, right where that one is, we should leave that rock and, like, build to it.
Yeah, exactly. Because okay. If you can build it up to the size of the channel, then it'll spill and overflow, and you'll also get a lot of water built up behind it. Like, this is the perfect place to build it right next. I think that's catclaw acacia.
Sebastian, we're going to go up here a little bit, but...
No. I don't know what this is.
Pick the perfect spot, Sebastian.
The soil's still a little moist down there. What is this?
There's a really nice rock y'all could use right here.
Yeah, if you want to, we'll clear the way. Right, look out below. Watch out, James, because I don't know what... It shouldn't roll to you, but...
Okay. I mean, it looked like it'd roll a lot better.
Can I try and do that?
Oh, yeah. If you want to try and pick it up and throw it, because that one's,
Oh! You know what Daniel was saying, Seamus?
Yeah.
We need more 20, 25-year-olds out here.
Exactly.
Oh, it's just cardboard. Well, here, we'll put it at the bottom of the new dam.
Oh, you mean like the wall, the rocks and stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah, like a base, okay. I guess.
Yeah.
And this one we'll build pretty good size because we have this thing flooding down into here. Kind of thin pickings up here.
You need to go grab a pickaxe?
No, because I don't want to erode the hillside.
Ah.
If I loosen the material, it's going to get real bad.
Yeah.
one step and half the rock fell off.
Get that on the rock did me a favor.
I don't know if it caught it. I was watching because I was filming up in this area. It was funny.
He said, did you see that?
Yep.
There we go.
Jeez, I got a monument.
Moving on.
Yeah, it looks good, guys. Y'all did great. They'll actually backflood all the way to the next dam.
And over it, maybe, yeah.
Yeah, because like, you basically try to get sort of ballpark line of sight and make sure that the very bottom of the dam
is the top of this,
is the top of this dam.
Yeah, and for the one we did over there, the site chose us. We didn't really choose the site.
Is that where the mega rock was that, that they were talking about?
Yeah.
I'm going to regret having all these sunflower seeds in my mouth on camera, but I really need the salt.
Ew, the size of that thing, man.
Yeah. There's so much water, it's going to get stuck in
there. And then we'll see. Then we'll see which ones work and which ones get washed out and all that.
I just can't believe how fast it's going.
I'm so happy to have y'all out here.
And we're
so
pleased.
Pleased. Yeah. So thank you. Yeah, there's about 450, 500 of them.
Wow.
So is all of this going to have bathtubs eventually?
So I'm changing the strategy.
Uh-huh.
I talked to an ecological restoration specialist. And he said this angle here is actually perfect for terracing.
Oh, okay, like...
Yeah, so basically building stair steps. And, like, on this hill here, like, this part's a little too steep at this rolling part up there. I can just get a bulldozer, knock it all to the side, and I don't want to do it all in one fell swoop because I don't want horrible erosion.
Yeah.
But if I just start on the top, run a bulldozer, wait for a rain, If that holds and does well in a heavy rain, do the next layer and you just do it section by section, start at the top of the hill. That goes so much faster than the bathtubs. The bathtubs, using a mini excavator took us 3.5 days for 2 acres.
Wow.
So, you know, bulldozers should easily get an acre a day.
Have you considered buying any equipment?
Yeah, I'm gonna have to buy a bulldozer. If we do that, I'm not sure that that's the strategy I'm going to follow.
Yeah.
But that guy's helping me make the excavation plan. So if it makes sense, yeah, because like it'll tie up a lot of money, but I should get the money back.
Yeah, exactly. Then you learn how to maintain and operate a bulldozer.
Yeah, exactly. It's a reason for me to buy some toys.
I know. And once you got a bulldozer.
Yeah, exactly.
Projects will be leaping in your mind.
Yeah, I know. It's going to be Pandora's box.
Yeah.
Like, there's no putting it back in when I get equipment like that. But then I can fix the road.
Yeah.
Well, and you guys are saying, like, the road's not terrible, but... Gosh, then instead of having the road, I don't know if you noticed, it's almost like a river channel where it goes down and up. I can run the dozer blade and push it up so that the water's not... funneling on the road.
Yeah.
Oh. Surprise!
Follow the wave.
When I first heard the term regenerative farming, I'm like, that's the right term.
All about it.
Yeah. Because you're like, yeah, you think about it. Rather than basically, I mean, they treat their farm like a mine.
Exactly how they treat it.
Yeah.
I just don't like it from a business perspective. Like, you're putting so many inputs in, it's no wonder why that people are stressed and running on loans. And I'd rather make half the money and be resilient.
Right.
And not be worried about going bankrupt.
Right. Yeah. And your goal is beautiful land. Your goal is not how many weeks can I be in Hawaii.
Right.
This year.
Yeah, that's not my idea of wealth. I'd be bored off my rocker. I really would. Like, I want to work. What time is it?
Last I checked,
22.
Yeah, so that's always my goal, is to make it to noon. So why don't we wrap up, because it's not going to get colder. The only way to pass these afternoons is just to enjoy my little makeshift patio. I skipped most of the summer out here last year, so I haven't really evolved the system. I think this is probably my second to last time sleeping in the tent. And especially being out here in June, it's unbelievably hot. We have to stop working around noon. Today we managed to push to 12:40, Because building the rock dams, the check dams, isn't nearly as taxing as lifting sandbags nonstop. But there just comes a point where it's too hot and you are so sluggish that it just doesn't make sense to put in the time. It's better just to come hide in the shade and drink a bunch of water and lounge around.
What do you think is the most surprising thing about being out here?
The thing that surprises me is that people can let land get like this and leave it like this and just leave it. And this is why I'm here, because here's somebody going to change all that, and I'm totally down with that.
Right now I'm marking the GPS coordinates so that we can use the GIS folks to help estimate how much water we're trapping. And this isn't necessary. I just like numbers. And now I'm measuring the channel depth to figure out how high this wall is, where it's the water's going to come over. And this one happens to be 19 inches. Oh, man. You know what I was saying about don't act like prey? It's really, really cool. And it's in the shadows. And it's nice down here. But yeah, I'm acting like prey. Whoa. Oh, that's Sodal.
Oh, that's indeed.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's the same as that bush right there, too.
Yep.
Yeah, my dad couldn't remember the name of it. And then when you mentioned agave, I was like, maybe he forgot that. But no one really forgets agave. Like, that's... Sotol, you don't hear as much.
No, you don't. But I don't know about that variety of Sotol, but just like agave, you can make booze out of it. Oh, yeah. It's heaven. Yeah. I've never... It's hard to explain to somebody what it smells like out here when it rains, but so we built 28 check dams.
Oh, wow.
I mean, that's a lot for five guys. So what I'm going to do is ask everybody up to this point, how many, like, if you think about your time in this valley where you're actively working and stacking rocks, including breaks, how many hours do you think you worked today?
Four? No, it was more than that. It was like six.
Okay. Six. What I want to do is I want to calculate how many gallons per man hour do we think we're trapping permanently because of people coming out here and stacking rocks.
And then figure out what the numbers are for the other methods.
Pretty much, yeah. Like, what makes the most sense? Because, you know, and it's totally logical. Get the biggest equipment, you move the most earth, but there's also a heck of a lot of water and we're stacking rocks real fast. So, man, that Sotol is huge.
Yeah.
It's also gorgeous. It's in great shape. Mm-hmm. It's one of the few plants out here that looks like it's genuinely thriving.
Yeah. Have you seen the yuccas throw up any stalks and do flowers yet?
Yeah, I was eating them last month.
Okay,
yeah. Oh, really? Have you had them before?
Yeah. They're good. They kind of just taste like a little sweeter lettuce.
See, to me, it tasted like an acidic cauliflower. I loved it. It was like, it wasn't the flavor right away. Mm-hmm. Also, were you eating it fresh, like pulling it right off?
Yeah.
Like, it just had this aftertaste that would linger in my mouth for like 5 minutes, and it was so good. But,
also, it's cool to pick stuff off of it and pick stuff off the earth and eat it.
Exactly.
That's part of what makes it taste good.
Yeah, exactly. Like,
if it doesn't taste completely awful, it's just a win already.
Totally agree. Getting around the branch, it's really important to have the right footwear. And that's why I love having the old rugged Vellies on my feet. They're cheap, they last forever, and they're just so easy to slide on and off my foot that for quick work where I'm just gonna do errands around the ranch, they're my favorite footwear. As I'm filming this, I've only published 7 episodes, and already the expertise in this community, you, the viewer, are making a difference in the plan that I'm likely to go with. I haven't absolutely finalized that I'm going to use a bulldozer and terrace because, well, I haven't actually finished the excavation plan. I still think dirt bathtubs are going to play a role in the more steep spots, but they may take a back seat to the primary strategy. So I think I'm being very accessible. I am listening to y'all, and I'm enormously blessed to have 2 or 3 million, I don't know how, millions of people have watched these videos now. And never, my goal with the first episode, I thought, man, if I get 10,000 views on the first episode, we're killing it. And that one's already coming up on 2 million views. And what I never expected out of this experience was to have the feedback drive the real-time development of this project. So up to now, I've been telling it on a serious lag where everything runs a year in the past, more or less. But I'm seeing the value of giving you guys the real-time updates because you give me feedback that is really important to me. So please keep those comments coming. And thank you for watching. And if you want to talk to me directly or you want to have even more detailed updates on what's happening in real time, make sure you go to dustupsranch.com and sign up for the email newsletter. That's the only way I'm communicating in real time with subscribers. It's where I announce the volunteer events. Make sure you sign up, stay updated, and I'll see you in the next episode. Thank you for watching.